That track is a jam. That is one of my all-time favorites. We are listening to Non-Tech Level Music 1 from Bob, or B.O.B. for the Sega Genesis version. Love that tune, and that is, again, chosen because it has the word tech, Apple, or computer somewhere in the title of the game, the title of the tune, and then I guess also in the composers, and possibly the company lists, because we did play a Technos track recently that was not connected to any of those terms except through the word Technos. So, hi everybody, welcome to Apple IIsday. I apologize right out of the gate because I appear to be dropping a lot of frames. So, I hope that that's not going to affect the experience too much. Let me know if it gets really bad. But in the meantime, let's bring up the lights and the camera. Hello! I am so excited about the stream tonight because we are going to be continuing on from where we left off last stream with the KoalaPad. Bum ba ba! So if you were here last week, we started using this Apple IIe, or Apple, I think, IIc as well, for your Apple IIe and IIc. This is actually a sticker on the box. I think that's kind of interesting. So that was added for some reason. Maybe people were confused. We started using the KoalaPad, and in the instructions it said not to use the tablet and a joystick at the same time, not to have them plugged into the different ports. And I didn't really think it was going to affect things too much, but it really seemed to. And somewhere deep inside of me, I was afraid that perhaps the KoalaPad was broken or not functioning properly. But before I started testing things for the stream tonight, I did remove the joystick and have confirmed that the tablet works. So I'm really excited that we're going to really dive into the functionality of it tonight. We kind of got a little teaser last week, but now it's really time. Hey, Nerd Noise Radio! B.O.B. is the B.O.M.B. Your connection is super crappy, so if you miss something, you're sorry. I don't think it's just you, Nerd Noise Radio. Although my percentage of dropped frames is going down, which is nice. But I have been noticing that on playbacks as well, so I do apologize. But let's, and my setup is a little bit weird. I know I say this a lot, but whenever I have to do, like, extra things, stuff gets weird. So I'm looking at my laptop right now, which I usually can kind of monitor while I'm streaming. But I have it bent down, so if I want to actually look at the laptop, I have to do this. And it's bent down because we are going to be using the second camera. Activate that disk drive. So I'm going to be up here with you, but we're also going to be down in the second drive so we can get a nice good look. Well, you know, a moderately good look, I will say, because this is the lesser of the two cameras. This is my built-in, and, you know, the angle isn't so great, but at least you can get the idea of what we're going to be doing down here while we're using it. So this is going to be our tablet cam, I suppose. So let me go ahead and fade this music out. Da-da-ba, da-da-ba, da-da-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. That track is so good. That's one of my favorite washing the dishes tracks for some reason. When I wash the dishes, I just want to be listening to that track. So I'm going to remove these so I'm free from that cord. And I thought, hey, Droogie, what's up? KoalaPad sounds like a lame name for fraternity house. My other camera is going to have low self-esteem. No, 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 no. My camera knows. My camera understands. I actually really like the, I like outdated technology, so I like how things get sort of stroby down here. But, you know, it's not its fault that you're not closer to the tablet. Really, it's my fault with all the things that I have around here in my kitchen. Yeah, firm the second camera, that's right. What would I do without you? If we didn't have you, the folks wouldn't be able to see this stuff. So I thought we would just begin again with the paint program that we were using last week, but I also have another program that I want to use tonight, which is a completely different beast, but which also uses the KoalaPad. So let's see what using the Apple II equivalent of MS Paint is like when we actually have a working tablet. Koala Micro Illustrator. I'm so crammed in over here. Okay. Ba-da-bum. And you do hold it like this. This is the bottom, and this is the top. And so we talked last time about how there's sort of an incline here, if you can see that on the bottom there. So if you were to just put it flat down on your desk, it would be kind of propped up a little bit for you, sort of drawing board style. And it's got two buttons. Nudes, what's up? Vortex Queen! Great winds of water pulls you here. Now you are lost. No! Suddenly, great winds of water. I love those messages. They really set the tone. How are you doing, Vortex Queen? How are you doing, Nudes? Jason says, Jason, hey, Jason! Did you have all of this growing up? Jason, no. I did not have the KoalaPad growing up. The KoalaPad was an acquisition. The KoalaPad was something that I always wanted, and I mentioned it to a friend of mine who is a collector of video games and things, and he remembered that I wanted one and found one somewhere out in the wild and picked it up and mailed it to me as a surprise, which was really super sweet. So, I did not have this growing up. I did have the Apple II that I'm using, and all of the Apple II stuff that I'm using tonight, aside from the KoalaPad, I did have. But this is a big aspect of this whole thing. So, ooh, what a cool story, says News of Dudes. Yes, Sloth! I love the sloths. I am on the sloth team. The Renaissance is not. That is fine. 611.5. Hope you are fine. Nudes is doing all right. How am I? I'm doing a lot better today. I'm feeling really good. I got some mundane life stuff figured out. I had a celebratory bubble tea. And now I'm here with all of you. And the tablet works. I was really afraid that it wasn't going to work. I was afraid maybe there was something wrong with it. Even though I don't think I've ever picked up a piece of Apple II technology that didn't work. So, I don't know if I've... It's a combination probably of being lucky, of knowing people who take good care of things, and then also the fact that these machines are built like workhorses. So, circa 1983. So let's do it. I'm going to go ahead and click the... Did you hear that nice springy click, by the way? So this is all familiar to us from last week, but last week when I kept putting the cursor down, it was just staying in one spot over here. But now, I'll do this so you can see, it will move to follow where I'm pressing. I'm not even pressing that hard. And we noted that the noise sounds kind of like writing with a pencil. Not kind of like, it sounds very much like writing with a pencil. It feels like writing with a pencil as well. There's like a texture a little bit to the drawing surface. But also, you know, it's everything is mapped. So if I press in the top left corner, the cursor appears over there. Bottom right, it zooms down to the bottom right. Top right, left right. So it does actually move over. I think that's kind of cool. It moves over to where you're pressing, but it is mapped, you know, the surface area, space, and coordinates of the tablet are mapped directly to what you're doing on screen, so you're not going to be doing any of the, like, it doesn't work like a touchpad on your laptop, right? I use a touchpad and I have to think about this, because you move things over. You might continue. Do you know what I'm talking about? You'll like drag and you'll run out of space, and then you'll lift up and then you'll start again, and the cursor will just continue from where you left it off. It's not bound to the coordinates. That's what I'm trying to say. What's our plan? Drawing the universe? Vortex Queen? No plan. I mean, I kind of expected it was just going to be vaporwave stuff, but we'll see. Maybe I should draw the asterite, or will that offend you? Should I draw you? Should we try to draw the Vortex Queen? That might be kind of neat. Nerd Noise Radio says, bubble tea is the best, taro is your jam. Do you get taro bubble tea? The bubble tea place near us doesn't have taro flavor. So I get passion fruit with golden boba. Jason K. says, my grade school had a room full of Apple IIs, your only exposure to them. Lots of obligatory Oregon Trail, Number Munchers, and Carmen Sandiego. Absolutely. Those are like the classics that basically everybody played in a library or a school setting. Vortex Queen says, many bubble tea vendors are closed now in Germany because the hype is over. Oh no! I love it. I feel like when you say you probably missed out on something, you will survive. But it's a cool experience, especially if you like to chew your drinks or drink your food. It's a very pleasant experience. Vortex Queen is horrifying. It's true. VQ takes that only as a compliment. Why don't we try? So, let us... Now, again, amber monitor, but you're seeing it in color, so I'm going to have to consult the laptop to make sure I'm doing things in color. We are shockingly lacking... There's a shocking lack, I should say, of browns. So I think the closest we're going to get is this one. So I'm just dragging over and I'm clicking, and it selected it. What is the other... All right, so the second button also selects, but it probably does something else on the canvas. We'll see. We'll see. Jason K says, you've only seen bubble tea served in Chinese restaurants. Wow. Oh, Nerd Noise Radio, I'm so envious that you have taro bubble tea. They have milk taro tea, but I can't drink that. It would have to be just regular tea. Yeah, I live in an area that has a lot of bubble tea and Asian restaurants, and it's fantastic. So just like a lot of standalone bubble teas. So that's all they serve. Let's do this. Actually, no, let's not do this. Let's use this. Actually, this is interesting. I wanted to use the circle, hoping that I'd be able to elongate it, but let's see what we can do. Let's start. So, when we were using the joystick last time, it was really hard to control the size of things, but here, you know, I don't know if you can see that I'm just sort of, you know, expanding the diameter by just sort of moving back and forth. So we start, I just let go and I'm hitting the button again and apparently that cancels out. So if we start here and I click and then I just drag away from the center point and then I can drag back towards the center point and I'm going to let go. So why don't we... I guess we are going to... I'm surprised that there isn't a... Oh, and I didn't fill it. Wait a second. Because I wanted disks. I wanted disks. I am surprised that we can't do an oval. Let's try this again. Let's cover up our work. All right. Off to a start. Let's see if we can do this from memory. And how are you all doing tonight? I don't think she's large enough. We need more majesty. This is the forehead. Nope, that's too far up. This is like the face. Oh, that didn't take. Let's try that again. Face. Fill. So the eyes are going to be over here. And then we need to do a jaw. This doesn't seem quite symmetrical. Let's try this again. Not that it has to be perfect. Okay. All right. I think it's looking slightly recognizable. Jason K says, I enjoy how old computers have to slowly draw the images they display. Me too, Jason. I loved that. I thought, as a kid, I thought that was a stylistic design of the Apple II. But... it's obviously related to memory. But it looks really cool. I wish that graphics on computers kind of still did that. you know, even though they don't need to for you know, memory reasons. But I thought that was such a cool thing to see things get drawn in. I completely agree. So we need to do a jaw. We do have a fill function, so why don't we... So she's got, like, mandible things, like this. Nope. Maybe. Vortex Queen, I apologize. We're gonna have a little bit of a... You're gonna have a little bit of an uneven jaw, I think. It's not too bad. Let's try to fill this in. Let's see. There were instructions on, like, if your fill goes wrong, so I'm sort of concerned that this doesn't seem closed off here. Yep. No, stop! So, they suggested... There is a whole section that was saying, if you fill incorrectly, like, just try to... There's no undo, is what I'm trying to say. So they suggested that you just try... Oh, to cancel, erase, lift finger from the tablet and press either button. Select color to erase. Whoa, that's kind of cool. Oh, no, did we just... Oh, no, we just ruined the whole thing. I thought we were going to do that MS Paint thing where you can select a particular color and if you, like, erase, if you rub over it, it will erase only that. So, alas. Well, we've won the game. So why don't we... What happens if we... So we can't fill this black. It's because it's a textured color as opposed to a solid color, which is kind of interesting. So... I know there's a way to start over. We read about it, but I can't remember. So let's look at the help. Vortex Queen says, okay, I won't complain too much if you end up as an elephant seal. Nerd Noise Radio says, there needs to be a game that deliberately uses that aesthetic of the draw. And I agree, I think it's really neat. Control Z. There's not even a... Well, no, there is a control button here, but yeah, that's funny. Okay, let's see. I guess we don't have what I need to know. Erased. To cancel erase, select color to erase picture. So if we do this, does that mean we're gonna... Okay. So that's basically just a wipe. So we're telling it wipe the whole thing, but fill it in with a particular color. All right, let's begin again. Let's begin again. Vortex Queen. Majestic forehead. Face. It's off center. This is so cool though, folks. I'm like really excited about using the KoalaPad and doing this. This is really neat. This is super cool. Okay, so Let's do a box then for the jaw. So, mandible. Not bad. Let's do what other colors do we have? Oh, red. Wait, have I been doing this in blue this entire time and not the brown? And I can't tell? Yep. Oh no, but now how do I fill this? Because it's a textured... On my screen, this color and this color look exactly the same. So I just thought that I had chosen the red. So I don't think that I can just fill this. No. So we're going to have to actually draw over it. Such is the experience of old tech. I'm disappointed because those mandibles were looking nice. It's okay. She just gets more majestic every time we do this over, is really what's going on here. Jason says, I wonder if this can be replicated on a Wacom tablet and an Apple II emulator. I bet it can. If Brigand is out there, Brigand's the one who knows how to use the Apple II emulators. Did we cover that up? Yes, we did. We had a heat warning today in Southern California. It's late October, and it was mid-90s. Super bizarre for someone who is spending their first year here. Vortex Queen says, actually, I can code it for you if you like. This really isn't that complicated. Really? So Vortex Queen, I don't know if you were here for earlier streams where we actually showcased a program that Brigand wrote, but I do like to showcase programs that people do. So if you're thinking about working on something, I would love to try to implement it into the stream. I don't know if I'd be able to implement an emulator thing, but I would at least want to tell everyone about it and show them so that they could do it too. So if you're willing to put something like that together, I know that people would be very, very excited. Okay, I'm conflicted now about what to do next. I want to do the eyes. And the eyes should be like this red. Now I have to double check to make sure that everything is good. Good to go. Vortex Queen says, oh, this is sweet. Would be cool, sure. Yeah, definitely. I guess maybe we should just... Oh, wait, no. Wait a minute. Oh, I'm still in the block. I want the discs. I was like, why isn't it anchoring to the center point? I'm sorry, this is making me giggle. This is gonna be like the chibi version of the Vortex Queen. Actually, I feel like this is suitably terrifying. Your eyes are a little bit uneven. Now they're more uneven. This is looking kind of Invader Zim-like. I kind of like the uneven eyes. That's funny. You like your typical October cool weather, thanks. I know, I'm nostalgic for the cool fall, for sure.
Your eyes just keep getting bigger and bigger.
All right, how are we gonna do the teeth? And I do wanna do like the ribbing on the forehead. Some good ribbing on the forehead. I'm trying to remember exactly what the teeth look like. And how are we going to do this? Probably lines, I guess.
And I guess we'll do
white for the teeth. Although I feel like they should be outlined in a different color. Maybe we're going to have to kind of lay down the teeth and then accent them. Yeah, okay, so I have a better idea. Why don't we do... Let's do another box. So we're going to like put down the backing color and then draw the details over, which is not how I would normally do it. I would want to draw the details and then fill in, but I think that we would be better served to kind of do something like this, maybe? It's like a weird green line over there. Is that overhanging from, That's not right. Okay. I'm gonna regret this. I'm gonna let this go.
There's like a green line that I see that I
I didn't think was I guess we can just put the mandible over it. Let's do that. Let's make sure we pick the right color. This one, right? So if we just kind of inch this over a little bit, does it get rid of the green? Yay! All right. Excellent. So the Vortex Queen has like bottom teeth that protrude. So we should put in a spiky spike. Guam, she says. Guam. And by the way, this tonight should be a very kind of free-form conversation night, I think. Because, you know, I'm just putting around. Putting around. I have no idea what I just said. Putting around.
So it looks like the green is showing up because of the way the Apple II handled color is really sort of fascinating. And so it's struggling here, I'm sure you can tell. With the greens and the whites. It's colors that are next to each other sometimes are an issue. So, and I don't see that. And I'm just coloring in right now. I don't see that as I am working. So it's just something that kind of I have to look back and review. If I had a color monitor, I'd probably be able to compensate better in real time. This is so funny. All right, we gotta do some black lines now. So she's got like Guam. I'm gonna be making Vortex Queen sound effects. Head down. I thought we were going to be able to get away. We were going to make more, be able to make more pointy teeth in here than I think we are going to be able to. This is too good. So, and then she's got a little bit of pointy teeth up top here. Like that. This is amazing. Let's clean this up a little bit. There is also a way to go in closer, you know, magnify. Oops. There's no undo, we have to live with it. So you could really get in there and do some very close work if you really wanted to. This is too funny. I want to see if I can draw. This is that red color. Where's this green? It's like over here. If I color in like this, does that get rid of the green? Oh, it kind of does. So I can kind of, I'm doing this blind on the amber screen, but I guess I can kind of clean things up a little bit, maybe? Oh, yeah! Yeah! Okay. I think that she's looking quite respectable. I am having a lot of fun right now. Is this a white line or a black line? This is a black line. Okay. We need to get some reflection in these eyes to make them look alive. Hey, Animite, what's up? This could be the evil red queen of Simant, says Jason. Oh, wait, right. I forgot. I immediately sort of defaulted to, you know, the MS Paint style of clicking a spot and it orients to the left
top corner as opposed to the center. I have to remember that this is center stuff. Can we get the creepy reflection going? Come here. Come here. All right, how are we going to do these forehead lines, though? And what color are we going to do them in? I guess we would want to do them in this color. And we can't do... we can't do ovals. So I'm trying to think how we would want to actually go about doing this so that it doesn't look silly. Nothing much. All is well. That's good to hear. We are currently trying to draw the Vortex Queen. Oh, you know what? Why don't we do... not discs. We shouldn't fill them in. Let's give her that nice... first, let's do... oh, these are like connected lines. That's interesting. We want like... did that work? Did it work? Hold on. It did not. Did I pick the same color? No. Let's see if that's going to take. Oop. That's the end of the tablet right there. I can't go much higher. And go.
There we go.
There we go. So maybe we should just do the radiating lines, kind of like... instead of going for the full globes, we'll just put the suggestion of the forehead here. This is starting to be sort of hard to look at on my screen. I like thinking that there are people who might be seeing this preview on like the Twitch browse page and be like, what the? Weird person doing. She's a gentle monarch who kidnaps dolphins. Indeed, Animite. Jason K says she has puppy dog eyes. I know, she's very cute. It's like chibi Vortex Queen. I don't like that placement. Let's try this again. Whoa, really staring at this screen is starting to like... I wish I could show you what it looks like to me. That's not too bad. She's coming together. What? I can't think of what, like, this area looks like. So I think we might as well just leave it. She needs some kind of definition. Should I give her, like, little blush lines? Let's give her little blush lines. She'll be, like, super cute. Super cute, Vortex Queen. Best decision? Probably.
Look at her!
I'm sorry, I'm having the best time right now. So, alright. Let's draw the surrounding hive now. So let's do like this dark color. How far over can I go? That's the end of the screen there, so, like, and that's the bottom. Oops. Okay, so that's going to be an issue. If I drag too far to the bottom of the screen, it's going to sort of bring me back to the menu, because that's what it thinks I want to do if I pull all the way down to the bottom. So let's do like that. Let's go up here. I so want someone to come in the chat and be like, is that the Vortex Queen? And then my artistic talent will be justified, validated. Okay. We've got to put Echo in here now. The Vertex Queen hangs out with Hello Kitty. She does. We should put some jellyfish in here. And we should put some, we should put Echo. Let's do a few jellyfish over here. They should be little. We're gonna give them little, kind of trailing tentacles. Whoops, that was way too big. Let us... Oh, actually, since the white doesn't have... There we go. Since the white doesn't have texture, we can just fill it easily. Oops. Again, I want to do center, not side. So I know that last stream, some of us talked a little bit about our early experiences with paint type programs. So what were you all using? KidPix came up, and I loved KidPix. We had KidPix at school in our computer lab. My school got a computer lab filled with Macs, my elementary school, when I was in maybe fourth grade or so, and it was part of that Apple was like giving computers to schools at a very reduced price, which was a great business model for them because then all of these children got trained on the Apple computers, and then the idea being maybe they would grow up to be Apple users. But then we did actually get to practice computer skills and stuff. So that was where I used KidPix. And my favorite part of KidPix was that they had a paint program that also, there was a function in there that would generate a randomized sentence for you. So I would generate a random sentence and then I would draw the picture that was, you know, what the random sentence kind of was getting at. And I loved doing that. I loved having to come up with the picture, you know. Mario Paint. You know, I have never used Mario Paint because I didn't have it growing up. But I feel like there were tablets that you could buy that were their own standalone things that you plugged into your VCR or your line-in or whatever, and you could draw, and they had, like, along the side, they would have little buttons that looked like different colors in a palette, and you would, like, push into the color, and then it would change the color of your brush. That I loved. And I actually, like, recorded on VHS some of my drawings. I loved those. I thought they were cool. I had one. A friend of mine had one. And I loved it so much that we were able to get probably a less expensive version. It was different. But I loved that thing. So had I had Mario Paint, I would have been into that for sure. Da-da-da, Mario Paint. I think we're really capturing the majesty of the Vortex Queen right now. Okay, so now with this, I'm trying to remember exactly how this worked. Oh, yeah, that's right. Okay, so how do we... Somehow when I used the rays last time... Oh, wait, no, I don't want to do this. No, no, no. Okay, good. I just want an eraser, but I guess you don't do that, really. I guess the erase function is sort of misleading. I think you just sort of draw over stuff. I can't remember exactly how I did the lines last time. Let's just get rid of this. Just coloring over this stuff. Kind of like those dots, though, that are being left behind. It's sort of neat. Neat looking. Leave that. Looks cool. Let's see if we can figure out how to do these rays in white. Why don't we just do it over here? Okay, so that fills up really fast. So how do I... Huh. It's interesting how quickly that fills. The rays looked really cool last stream, but I can't figure out how to reproduce what we did. So let us just get rid of this stuff. Erase by coloring over. Jason K says, I use the composer part of Mario Paint more often than the drawing part. Yeah, I would have used that a ton also. I didn't even know that that was a function of Mario Paint. Dun, 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 Mario Paint, hang on. I really want this to work out for me. I want to make those, I want to make those jellyfish tendrils. It came with a mouse and a mouse pad. I think I may have to just manually draw in our little jellyfish friend. Tentacles. If we can even really tell what those are. And a mouse pad. It's kind of artsy, actually. That's kind of neat. That's kind of neat. Let's put Echo in. How are we going to do Echo? I think we should do, like, the curled up Echo. Oh, so hang on a second. We want to change our colors and stuff. So we want to change to blue. Actually, Echo is a lighter color. A mouse and a mouse pad. I forgot, not left orientation. Okay, so here's Echo. Yes, very nice. Thank you, Vortex Queen. This is the beginning of Echo. And I think we may just have to draw the rest. I should just be using the fill for this. We'll see how this goes. We may have to redo Echo. Da da dum, da da dum. But let's see if we can do something about this. Do 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 do. This is like, oh, I can see that it's, I sort of saw a weird ripple. I could see that it was changing the color around the line here. It's not too bad. Let's see if we can clean up this blue. Need some stars on the head. Your marks, the marks on your head look like stars in the sky. KeyGlyph is having entirely too much fun right now. I want this to be better shaped. Is it doing that weird color thing again? Kind of. That's really annoying, actually. Because I just can't see it. So I have to try to kind of color over what seems to be a discoloration. That might be the best that we can get it to be. Wah, wah, wah. Jason K says, Echo the Dolphin ported to Apple II. St. Wyatt and St. Chloe say hi. Hi, St. Wyatt and St. Chloe. How you doing? Anamite says, I didn't have much exposure to paint programs as a kid other than old MS Paint. And even then, I never got beyond making a few lines and a cacophony of colors. Jason K says, I had little experience with computers growing up since you never had one yourself. Yeah, so you started with better technology when you eventually got there. Echo looks sad. Kind of drooped. I want there to be like a heart involved or something. Or like hold on. What if can we do like a dialogue bubble? Can the Vortex Queen be suggesting peace? Now, how are we going to do a heart? Is a question. Might do two discs. Do we have a pink? We do have a pink. So we can at least do the two tips of the heart. That's not centered. Interesting that that doesn't want to be the same size at all. Oh, maybe it did come out the same size. And let's add the point. Here we go. Here we go. This is the sequel to Echo the Dolphin that, oh, maybe I should just use the fill, right? Will it, oh no, I don't want to use the fill. I'm afraid it's not going to work properly. And with no undo. I gotta tell you how interesting it is, how naturally this is already feeling to me. I've fallen right into using this tablet as if it's just a regular thing. Echo is deflated, it's true. You can see the dolphin in that. You gotta squint a little bit. It's hard when you can't go over with the black lines. Like, I wanted to, you know, actually draw details and things. But I can't, because if I draw over the blue, then it changes it to a different color. So I can't really go in and refine anything, which is sort of unfortunate. I almost want to remove Echo. Let's try Echo over again. Because I feel like the Vortex Queen is really stealing the show here. Should we even put Echo in, or should we put something else over there? What do you folks think? Nerd Noise Radio has to bail. Have a great night, St. John. Thanks for dropping in. Blah, 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 blah. Blah, blah. We definitely need something over there. Maybe we could just have a bunch of those, what color green didn't we use yet? Those things that shoot out of the wall that are a complete pain. Ba-dum-bum, da-da-dum, dum-da-da-da-dum. I just feel like compositionally we need something over here. Not having an undo is really hard to get used to. Yay, I kind of like it. I kind of like it. I feel like this is our masterpiece. The Renaissance! Excuse me, past the sun chips. Ren, how are you doing? Ren, look, I'm an artist! Isn't it beautiful? Please help yourself to the sun chips. Ren, when do you start? I thought you would be, this is art. I thought you'd already be streaming by now. Check it out, we're using this, KoalaPad tablet with the Apple II and drawing away. We're drawing Vortex Queen right now. Just got home, starting up soon. So I think I consider this a completed masterpiece. The only thing I didn't prepare was a disk to save this on. I'm not... Actually, hold on. Let me look. Because we were using a disk for the programs that we wrote. We do have an Apple IIe's disk. And so I should be able to save to this without overriding what's already on it. And if I do override what's already on it, that's kind of okay because I have all of that stuff written out, so I can just type it back in. But why don't we see what happens? Why don't we try to save this? We're going to go ahead and put this into slot 2 and finish off this experience of what it was like to create and save art on Apple II. What did I do with the tablet pen? There it is. I hate misplacing tablet pens. Okay, so can we save? We should be able to. And I have a manual, too, that we can look at. Which I think we are going to have to look at. Here we go. Although I wonder, so the manual that I have is not for this particular program. Oh, storage! It's right there in front of me. Hold on. It's like right in the midst of all the other art tools, so I just forgot that it was there. Storage. Okay. Catalog disk, disk file utilities, load standard, DOS 3.3 picture, save. Spacebar, return to menu, insert target disk. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and take out. I don't think I ever saved any of these things. So I'm taking out the Koala Micro Illustrator disk. And I'm putting in the Apple IIsday's disk into slot 1. And let us hit S. Oh, okay, I could have selected the drive. So why don't we... So now I'm nervous. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take the Apple IIsday's disk, put it back into slot 2. Because I don't want the paint program to need to access itself for some reason. The picture should be in memory right now. So all the Apple has to do is to put what's already in its memory onto the disk. But I'm afraid that for some reason it will access the paint program again, and then it will look for the disk that's not there and have a problem. So use the keyboard's left or right to select, press escape key to cancel. I want disk drive 2. Can I hit 2? Disk drive 2. Type the name of picture to save. Why is there a dot? I shouldn't put this in my mouth. I'm terrible about that. Let's call it Vortex Q. The fact that there was a dot there made me nervous, because that makes me think that that's a file extension dot. But we'll just go ahead and try this and see what happens. Working! How long am I going with this, Ren? You know, not too long. Maybe another half an hour or so. Half an hour or hour. Ooh, it worked. Now I'm kind of curious. Let's load disk drive 2. Type the name of the picture to load. I mean, it's already in memory, but I just want to see what it's going to do. Is it going to... Oh, look, it brings it up like that. Oh, that's so cool. The blinds effect. That was neat. That was cool. So I guess she's there. Press spacebar to return to menu. Oh, see, now it's accessing disk drive 1 again. It's accessing the paint program. So we did want it in there. So that's cool. So it's on that disk, apparently. So, hurrah, if you want that picture, I can print it out for you at a later date. Isn't that fabulous? That's fantastic. Droogie says, is YouTube loading extremely slow for anyone else tonight? You have cat vids to watch before bed. Droogie, I couldn't tell you, because I am not watching YouTube right now. So I cannot help you, alas. But maybe someone else in the chat can. What is it exactly? Sorry, late to the party. You don't recognize Vortex Queen? It's the spitting image. Didn't we nail it, Vortex Queen? Don't you feel as though that you are looking in a mirror? It's me. So, okay. Here's what I want to do next. This was super fun. to be able to explore the paint program. But drawing programs aren't the only programs that use the KoalaPad. So I want to grab another thing that I want us to try tonight and see how it functions with the KoalaPad. I always feel like I have to put the discs back in their exact sleeves, even though I know that growing up we just sort of moved the sleeves around all over the place. But there. Okay, so Koala Micro 2 is there, and then our Apple IIe disc is over here. Everything is settled and good. So now what I want to grab is not a cracked game, but an actual retail version of Music Construction Set. So I actually uploaded a bunch of videos of music from this game, just so that real hardware versions would exist on YouTube. This is a composition program like Sibelius or Cakewalk for the Apple II, and it has KoalaPad capabilities, so I wanted to see what it was going to be like to try to compose music while being able to drag the notes around. So I'm really excited about this. So, Music Construction Set. Now, the cool thing about this, one of the cool things about this, is this was programmed by a kid while he was still in high school. Let me find his little thing. I looked this up to make sure that this was really true, because it's written to be sort of funny. Oh, do you see him over here? Will Harvey. Let's see. Oh, here we go. There's stuff written inside this fold-out piece. So let me read to you what it says here. The expected. Born in the barren steppes of eastern Poland, Will Harvey, real name Ernst Czerny, was trained in music from birth and authored two symphonia, a host of nocturnes, and a whole batch of peasant lieder before he was old enough to play wiffle ball. The plausible. Will Harvey is the son of William Honkin Harvey, the famed country singer and former governor of Missouri. The youngest of 23 children, Will exhibited promising musical sense at an early age, but decided he preferred dismantling old electrical appliances. The truth. Will Harvey is an Eagle Scout, a 4.0 student, and president of the student body at Uplands High School in Foster City, California. He has played tackle football for 7 years now and has won first place twice in the physics division of the San Francisco Science Fair. See? We knew you wouldn't believe it. So I looked that up because I was like, is this all a joke or all of these a joke? But it continues. Some more truth. One day, Will was sitting in his advanced programming class as the teacher tried to plan out what they might study over the coming year. The teacher said, "Why don't we learn machine language? That would be fun. Does anyone know it?" Will said he knew it. Will did not know it. "Okay, Will," said the teacher, "maybe you could give us all a presentation tomorrow." Will learned a lot about machine language that night. Some more truth still. That was 1 year ago. Will was 15. So when he was 16, he finished this Music Construction Set program. So a 16-year-old created what we are about to experience tonight. So I'm going to go ahead and put in the Music Construction Set disc, and I'm going to put my headphones on because we should be able to hear the music through our mocking board as opposed to the external speaker of the Apple, internal speaker of the Apple. So we're going to stick this in and we're going to reboot. Here we go. J-Rod, good evening. All right, so let me see. I forget exactly how I set this up, like if I have to make decisions right now about how the music is going to play or if the demo is smart enough. I think the demo is smart enough to figure it out, but we'll see. I'm going to wait for the demo and see what happens. How are you doing, J-Rod? Droogie's struggling with... There, do you hear it? Is that too loud? Vortex Queen says, this Apple II boots faster than your PC, right? Nudes of Dudes confirming that Droogie's phone is evil and is trying to confound his grammar and spelling at every turn. Is that volume okay for you folks? Let me know if that's too loud or too soft, because I'm not hearing it at the same level that you are. J-Rod is well. How am I? I am having a great time right now. I'm so excited to be able to use this KoalaPad for these programs. And I actually printed out a little video game tune that I'm going to try to replicate in this program. A very simple little tune. Animite says, whoa, and stereo, baby, right? So the Mockingboard, again, was a sound card expansion that you put into your Apple II, so it's not part of the motherboard. You actually put it into one of the slots on the motherboard that allows for expansions. And it enables, I think, 4 different channels in each ear, but obviously stereo, multiple channels, and different textures, which is really cool. It's good, says Snooze and Dudes. Flight of the Bumblebee? Yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and, well, I guess we'll finish listening to Turkey in the Straw. Just so you can get more of a... because why not? Okay. I have hit return with the stylus, because why not? Okay, so we're not using the mouse, we're using the KoalaPad! Boom! And we are using the Mockingboard C, I believe. Okie data, yes. Super serial card, I just always choose this. Seems to work, I think. Simon, I see that square, circle, and triangle next to the fractions. Was this made by Electronic Arts? In fact, my friend, it was. That is the company on this. All right, is this gonna work? Oh my gosh. Folks, not having had this KoalaPad growing up, do you have any idea? Is this even gonna work? This was my experience before, placing notes. Was having to do this. Having to basically play track and field to grab a note and to put it where it should be. I think then you either hit return or space or something and it grabs it. Oop. It's probably confused because it's like, why aren't you using the KoalaPad? So, let me see about this piece of music here. I'm probably going to wind up singing it. And this is key that this is in is a problem. So we're changing keys here. We want the key of B. Look at all those sharps. Is this not fascinating? It's fascinating. Oh dear, that would be maddening. It was, but I still tried, Simon. I still really tried. So we're just going to do some... of this. So again, I'm just following this sheet music that I printed out. I like that it gives us the lines so we can see where we are. That's quite helpful. This is so much easier. Oops. Move down. So let's see. Let's play it. Okay, can anybody... we gotta actually slow that down. Where is our tempo? I am not sure how to do tempo. Let's consult the manual for music instruction set. I did read through this. If anybody can guess what that tune is already, that would be amazing. Okay. Tells the computer how to scroll the music so that the... oh, by the way, another thing that the Mockingboard allows for this, if you don't have the Mockingboard, you can still use Music Instruction Set. It just uses the internal speaker of the Apple. but it won't. An extra functionality that you get with the Apple, the Mockingboard, is that you'll see the music scroll, which is kind of neat. Let's see. Okay, sounding. If you don't care whether the scrolling speed fits, ignore the time signature. Well, time signature. I want tempo. The manual. Let me actually show you the manual real quick. Oh, my left leg is very asleep right now. And I'm knocking stuff over. Ah, there's too much going on. Manual. But the way it's organized, it's just a wall of text in here. So, you know, let's hold it up here so you can maybe see it a little bit better. But it's not really separated into categories very well. It doesn't read easily to the eye. So I don't see, like, a nice list of, like... Oh, speed! Moving the gauge marker up and down changes the speed. Oh, I see it. Here it is. Sp is speed. Okay, let's try this. That's about the speed that I want. Duck Hunt! J-Rod, amazing. Simon says, Shovel Knight? It's not Shovel Knight. Anamite says, if only you had the NES power pad to help you with that flurry of key presses. I know, right? I would be so fit, also. I would have been the most athletic child on the block. Air Fortress, no. Mozart hype. Yes. Who else is in here? There are a lot of great composer... pictures in here. Okay. Let me continue. I'm trying not to... I can't... So, if you've watched my streams before, you're probably familiar with how much I sing along to music and how much I sing in silence as well. There's always or often music running through my head, and I will sing without even realizing that I'm singing. I'll just do it as I'm going about my life. But right now I'm aware of it because I don't want to sing the tune and ruin it, even though it doesn't actually really matter if you know what it is. But I feel it trying to come out. You can name that tune in 8 notes. When I finish this phrase, if you know this tune, you will definitely know what it is. So we need some more of these. Quarter note, half note, 16th note. Let's see. Whole note, half note, quarter note. Oh, nope. I knew that was wrong. I could hear it was wrong in my ear. Come on, grab it. Why won't you move it? We moved the other one so easily. Uh-oh. There we go. This. Let's add these now. So I'm just, oops, nope. So I'm just clicking and dragging. Give me this. And I hope that's applying it to this note. It looks a little funky, but I hope that's correct. Let's try it. Okay, it's not registering that dot for some reason. Let's go back. What if I... I'm not sure how to make it register that dot. Maybe it won't until I finish the phrase? I'm not sure, but let's see. these. And we want one of these. And we want... Oh, this is wrong. Come back down. And we want to tie these two together. I forget how to do that. That may not have done it, but let's see. The second one registered the dot. We need the first one to register the dot. Why won't you? Let's try putting it in a slightly different spot. There it is! Almost! Almost! So let's... That looks like it might be the sweet spot. Nope. So now we just have to, like, fiddle to make it work the way we want it to. This one is being held for too long for some reason. Close. Close. Does anybody know that tune? Ba dee da dun da 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 dee da dun da 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 dun da dun da 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 ba da dee da 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 dun da 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 dun da 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 dun da 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 ba da dee da da da. This is so exciting. So then you can actually copy and paste stuff. Sounds familiar. You can copy and paste measures. You can move things around in groups. So this program actually gives you a lot of functionality that I'm not even showing you. These are the ways that we control the actual sound of the note. So that kind of legatoed it. What does this do? That's the left ear. Simon says, I'm still having trouble not hearing J. Kaufman's Shovel Knight. Really? That's interesting. Man, someone's going to be having a lot of fun with this later. So you may have noticed that things in the treble clef are going to be in your right ear, and things in the bass clef are going to be in the left. Let's put that bass clef note in here, because we've got one. Oh, interesting. It has come out as a drum. So, let's see. Is this volume? It is volume. So... Let's see. I know this doesn't make for the most riveting stream, I'm sorry. I'm so excited. I don't know why it's not registering this, though. That bothers me a little bit. You were very excited. That makes for a good stream, says J-Rod. Thank you. I'm glad. Yeah, it's there's something about that. What happens if I just get rid of that? That's not properly metered out, but that's actually more like what I want to happen. I think part of our issue is the tie that I put in. Come here, you. Come here, you. Oops. Maybe if I move you out of the way. There's all this stuff in the manual about how to place these things and how to, you know, actually get everything to get the program to recognize what you actually want to do. Your reaction last week when it worked was awesome. I was very excited. I'm gonna finish the next measure. And then I'm gonna see about saving this, because then I can come back to it and fine-tune it and make sure that I can really get it to work. Because obviously where you place things really matters, how you get the sort of like the augmentations of different notes, where you put those matters. Oh, wait. This notation I'm working off of might be wrong also. But that's something that I can do another time. Ba-dee-da-bum-ba-da-dum. Is that a... That was wrong. Da-dee-da-dum-da-da-da. Da-da-da. Da-da-da. Da. And I don't know how much it matters if I've crammed things in properly. Nope, that's not right. That's too high. Right. Okay, let's see what happens here. Okay, yeah, so it actually really does, it's not automatically, I don't think, calculating exactly where things... It's not... It doesn't sound like the program is looking at the measure and saying, okay, you jammed all these notes in here, and I understand how mathematically that should be set up. It is actually kind of reading as it goes. It's like reading my really sloppy notation. So, like... Let me see. Can I grab this? Oh, I did, and then I lost. So let me just see something here. Oh no, it actually... I thought that, well, there's still something funny going on. It does seem to me like it's not just reading the mathematical equation of the measure and figuring out, okay, we've got this many beats, and it's notated like this, so even if I move things and put them in weird spots, it's going to come out right. So I think that cleaning up would be necessary. And obviously there are going to be weird sort of quirks to this that need to be figured out. I know there are some really interesting explanations in the manual, so hold on. Let me see what it says about... adding the little notations and, like, hints and stuff. Ba-dee-da-bum-ba-da-dum, dee-da-bum-ba-da-dum. Dee-da-da-da. What's interesting, too, is how much this manual tries to teach you music theory, too. It doesn't just tell you, here's how you use the program, but it will actually start explaining things. Like, for instance, there's a section here called Why the Key Names Don't Scroll Through the Window in Alphabetical Order. A staff with no sharps or flats to the left of the double bar is tuned to the key of C. If you start on C and move from line to space to line, etc., up to the next C, the pattern you hear is whole step, whole step, half step, whole step, whole step, whole step, half step. Remember the missing half steps between E and F and B and C. When you turn on the key change command, the first option it will offer you is G, to create the same whole step, half step, etc. pattern. Beginning with G, you need a sharp on F. Everything else stays the same. Blah, blah, blah. So they're actually teaching you music theory, which is pretty neat. They were expecting that somebody picking up this game, because I guess it is a game, you know, this program, wouldn't necessarily be a composer or a musician. It was expecting that there would be people picking up this program who were not musicians at all and maybe needed a little bit of a primer to understand what was going on. So I think that's kind of neat because the way it's targeted matters, if that makes sense. Oh, my legs are so asleep. Oh, my gosh. Ah. So what I'm going to do now, just for a little bit longer, I'm not going to stream for all that much longer, but why don't we just mess around with this and see what happens? Like, if we change the key, is it going to shift all of our notes? Oh, look at this. It's not letting us change the key. It's like, no. What if we change it to 6/8 time? What happens? Is it going to recalculate? Is it going to play like a mess? So, do you see? Okay, there's a number scrolling at the bottom. This, the thing that's currently 5. As it plays, it's counting the beats in the measure. And when it turns white like that, it means that there's something wrong with the calculation of the beats, which is true because we're missing this thing. So if we do this, let's see if that turns white or if it understands what we're trying to do here. Yeah, it still thinks there's something wrong. So that's cool though. So there's actually kind of like a built-in check for you so you can see where there's a problem, which is pretty neat. Simon says, I just tweeted you the Shovel Knight theme, but realized I could just post it here. If you post a link here, it's not going to show up on the Apple II, right? Correct. It's just going to show up in the chat boxes. Gobbledygook. Don't wake them. They'll be grouchy. What did I say? I'm not even sure. It's not from a musical. No, it's from a video game. It's from a video game. But, so it won't let us change the key. Let's just add... Man, like, what isn't sharp, though? Is this going to make this a double sharp? Oh, you can hear that it is... Oops. It is altering the note. It's playing, like, a little preview of it in your ear so you can hear it as you place it. That's pretty cool, too. Oh, and then let's try... So... I believe this is copy. Nope. Uh-oh, what did I do? Did I cut instead? Or... Let's see, copy and pasting. Using cut and paste, page 7. Let's see. Nope, that's telling me how to do something else. Not quite. Controlling speed. Oh, using cut and paste to create music. Page 2. Alright, the easiest way to learn about cut and paste is to use them. Okay, so we're going to write it. Next, turn the scissors on. Hold on, let's see. Okay, so it wants me to turn on the scissors. I'm just following the directions here. Turning on the scissors, which to me means cut. And not copy, but that's interesting to see the differences in kind of like the standards of things. So we look at scissors and we think that's just gonna erase it. You know what I mean? But this may actually be the Control-C.
Turn on the scissors, place them over the measure you just entered, and press the one key on the keyboard.
That will pick up one measure. So why don't I just click? I just clicked with the button.
The measure will disappear from the screen, but don't panic. It's sitting in a buffer and can be brought back with the paste pot. Just turn on the paste pot, place it over the measure where you'd like the measure to reappear, and paste.
But I want to paste it again.
Repeat the above steps for each of the measures.
But if I do this, it's going to disappear again, isn't it? Maybe it's not. I thought if I did this, it was going to disappear again. Do I have to scroll over? Interesting. I don't understand.
There's actually an exercise in the manual to follow about copying and pasting something. So why don't we... That brings us back home. How do we get rid of stuff?
Uh-oh, hang on. I lost chat. There you are.
Da-dee-da-dun-da.
It's a bottle of paste! Animite says, I thought it looked like a squat little lighthouse. Yeah! Simon says, I thought it was a baby bottle. I didn't know enough about music to know if that's not right. Yeah, we all learn this when we learn music. Are any of you folks musical? I had a friend growing up who made me understand that reading notated music was like reading a different language. Because to me, since I had always been doing it, growing up playing different instruments and, you know, going to piano lessons, playing in band, all that kind of stuff, that it just seemed like, well, it's not that hard. And I remember talking to her and saying, well, but you can at least tell that this note is lower than this note, right? And she said, no, I have no idea what that means, because she hadn't had any musical training whatsoever. So everything I'm doing might just sound like gobbledygook. I just want to delete stuff. I just want to get rid of this. I just want to get rid of this. Oh, stuff went away. Why won't this go away then? Okay. See how it matters where we click? Let's change to the key of C. Why won't you let me change to the key of C? No, not C sharp, C. There we go. I want to follow this little example that they have in the book because I think that that might be kind of cool. They want us to copy the song Brother John and then use the copy and paste to make it into a round, basically. Vortex Queen says, I am a musician. Yes. Excellent. Jason K says, I had a crummy keyboard when you were a kid. Crummy 90s keyboard. Let's do this exercise. And it will be a little bit laborious. So, over the double line. Are you sleeping? So, let us do what it says.
Okay, to write the music, start by copying the Are You Sleeping measure into the first blank measure in the top set of lines. Next, turn on the scissors. This is what I just read, but let's do it again. Turn on the scissors and place them over the measure you just entered and press the one key on the keyboard, but I'm just going to go ahead and press the Koala pad key. Okay. Turning on the paste pot. Place it over the measure where you'd like Are You Sleeping to reappear and press the button of your pointing device, or return if you're in keyboard mode, and then press it again to put down the second Are You Sleeping line you need for the song. So it's... Oh my goodness, what just happened? Wow, what happened? KoalaPad, hello! Well... I don't think there's any salvaging this. I think this is the end. Jason K says, I remember you could look at the staff and remember the word face to know what notes were. That's right, F-A-C-E, and every good
boy does fine, or all cars eat gas, and I don't know what the F-A-C-E equivalent was in the bass clef, because it's A-C-E-G. Oh, all cars eat gas. So F-A-C-E, every good boy does fine, all cars eat gas. Was it farmers grow dates and eat berries? Is that... Let's see. No. Because it would be... good boy does fine always. Someone out there knows what I'm saying. A crash? That's sad. It is sad, Animite. Simon says, I think you and I may have played many different games growing up. I might not know what the song is. You only have two guesses, Ultima or Echo. You haven't heard this song on your VG Embassy appearances. Simon, these are good guesses, but it's not an old game. It's a relatively new game. But these are good guesses. And I have not played it on any of the VG Embassy appearances. Da dee da 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 da. If you've played the game, you would know it. So I'm gonna keep it a mystery, because what I would like to do is I would like to use this program to do a VG Keys someday. So the Renaissance, who was in the chat earlier, he's a painter and a streamer and a musician, and he started this thing called VG Keys, hashtag VG Keys, where on Thursdays he posts a piano rendition of some VGM that he likes. And he's gotten other streamers on board, so Redox PDX is doing it, and I think Lip is also doing it. But I want to use this program to do a VG Keys. So if I do release it as a VG Keys, then you will know. But I'm going to keep it a secret until then. Why don't we try one more time to enter in the Are You Sleeping, Brother John, and see if we crash it again, and then we will move into someone else's stream via raid. But let me see. The measure will disappear from the screen, but don't panic. Just turn on the paste pot, place it over the measure where you'd like Are You Sleeping to reappear, and press the button on your pointing device. Then press it again to put down the second Are You Sleeping line you need for the song. So I'm wondering if I'm not supposed to click in the next measure, or if I'm supposed to actually just double click in the same spot and it will just add. So we will see. We shall see. Beep up, bup, 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 bum. Beep up, bup, bum, bum. Jason K says, I don't know new games very much. You live too much in the past. I don't know a lot of new games either. I'm trying to think, like, I realized the other day, I know I mentioned this on stream before, but the last Mario game I played, like an actual released Mario game, was Mario 64. The modern games that I play are games that I see my husband play that I get interested in, or games that friends give to me, or games that people come up to me and they say, this game was made for you, you need to play this. So there are a lot of modern games that I know I would really like that I just haven't gotten into, and not because I'm avoiding them, but just because it takes me forever to buy a game. And I do feel, so Jason K, I think we are of the same mind in this, that like when I get excited, like I want to buy a new game, I'm always getting excited about some old game. I never think to keep up with modern games, really. I'm always thinking about like, oh yeah, that cool game that I never got when I was a kid, or you know, oh, somebody just, I just heard the music from the Sega Genesis game, it sounds awesome, I want to try it out, you know? Like I just keep thinking like, man, I really want to play Alien Soldier, like these, ugh. And I know that, like, The Messenger is a great game. I know that Baba Is You is a great game. These are all games that have been recommended to me, but for some reason it's something like Alien Soldier that's going to just be, like, in the back of my mind always. Mario 64, same here. Wow, Jason. We're on it together. The newest non-computer game hardware you have is a DS Lite. The newest non-computer game hardware that is mine is a 3DS. Is that true? Because we have a PlayStation 4, but that was really kind of bought for my husband. He was the one who really wanted it. I use it too, and I love having it. But had he not really wanted it, I don't know that I would have bought it on my own. I think that's true. And I bought the 3DS. I bought Okay, so actually, here's my story with the 3DS. I bought the 3DS because I wanted to play DS games on a bigger screen, 3DS XL. But what it turns out that the 3DS XL resolution is not the same as the DS resolution, so it doesn't scale perfectly. So when you play DS games on a 3DS, it looks kind of like a blurry JPEG a little bit, enough that I noticed. And I was just like, oh man, why did I buy this then? That's like 80% of what I wanted this for. So it's basically my Animal Crossing New Leaf device, and that's like all I use it for. And I wound up getting a DS XL, and I use that into infinity, because that obviously scales perfectly. Jason K says, if I happen to play a new game, it looks like an old game anyway. I'm really into the retro aesthetic. I love that kind of art. So anything that's made to look like that, I will kind of be intrigued to play. Vortex Queen says, the newest not PC hardware I have is a Dreamcast, and it's still next gen to me. Yeah, to me, the Dreamcast is like right on the edge of retro. And we could talk forever about our personal definitions of retro, because some people make a clear delineation of year, or they make a clear hardware break-off, or it's about aesthetic and not about time. Like, there are tons of different ways to do this. But to me, when I think about my experience with video games, the Dreamcast was the future, and it's the last thing. It's really, I think Dreamcast and earlier is considered retro in my head, because the Dreamcast was when I was the last console that I actively really cared about. So everything beyond that seems like, you know, futuristic, bananas tech. It's mystery. It's mysterious and scary. But the Dreamcast is still homey. So my definition of retro is almost kind of just dependent on what I loved growing up. Completely subjective definition. But when I talk to other people, I mean it more in terms of aesthetic. But 99% of the time, I am actually talking about an old game with retro aesthetic. So it's an interesting perception. Jason, you can set the 3DS to display 1:1. It uses less of the screen, but is actually, I think, in 1:1 mode, smaller than the DS 1:1. So it's clear, but then smaller than the screen. So I was upset. I was upset. Simon says, newer game with retro aesthetic. Are you sure this isn't a Shovel Knight tune? I'm absolutely positive, Simon. I'm absolutely positive. I've never played Shovel Knight, and I only know two tunes from it, and this is not one of those tunes. But hang on, we have to successfully copy and paste a measure of Brother John. This is important. Over here. Are you sleeping? Okay, there it is. We're gonna scissors, cut, paste pot, paste, paste. Ooh! So you don't necessarily put it over the measure that you want. We did it. We did it. That's exciting. I'm just kind of curious now. If we paste again, is it gonna show up? Oh, it does! So I don't know why it wasn't quite working last time, but there you have it. There's some sweet functionality right there. Let's get rid of this note. Give me this note. Get rid of it. I don't want this one. Away. It's hard to grab them. I hope you can tell. This is a hard game. Come here. Come here. Please? Please? Can I grab this one? Hang on a second. What's going on here? We actually don't want this note either. Oh. Let's make this one. No! Okay, here we go. Move this one up. Come here. Oi! Why are we having so much trouble grabbing this one note? Here we go. No! There. Da da da! So we're gonna cut it, paste it, and let's go back to the beginning and listen to what we've composed. Yes, it is, Simon. It's Frere Jacques. Bogus, how are you? Hey, how goes it, everyone? Bogus, we are composing a round of Frere Jacques. Jason K says, oh, I see, like a Game Boy Color game on a GBA has a smaller screen size than on the actual Game Boy Color. Yeah, so, alas. Vortex Queen says, this one note made friends over there. Don't tear them apart! No! They're back here with everyone else. They're gonna be all right. We're following an exercise in the manual right now, Bogus. This cord getting caught on me is an issue. Da-dee-da-da-da-dum. This is making me think of Picard. Is anybody else really excited about the Picard series coming out? Da dee da 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 dum. Do 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 do. I'm not hyped to pieces about it. Like, what I mean is I'm not losing my mind actively over the Picard thing, but I'm very excited about it. I think it's gonna be really cool. Bogus says, awesome! You got that emulator software working, wink wink. You're just hoping, I hope he sings that in the new series, yep. Jason K says, Picard looks great, I'll have to wait until it comes out on video, though, to watch. Anamite says, in my heart of hearts, I still believe the tune is from Das Germanis der Happy. You can keep that in your heart of hearts. Der Happy Hippo. Isn't it funny how the weirdest games have become, like, household names to some of us because we all listen to the same podcast. Ding dong ding! Ding dong ding! Oh, this one. Ding dong ding! Da-dee-da-da-da-dum. Okay. Our masterpiece awaits us all. Okay. That's exciting, but we're not done yet. Let's go back home. There's more. Okay, let's see. When you finish, you should have a song 8 measures long, even though you only had to create 4 measures by the one note at a time method. And now for the really fancy trick. Turn the scissors on, place them at the beginning of the song, and press the 8 key. So we're gonna copy, I think, 8 measures worth. Yeah, okay. Presto, all 8 measures are cut into the buffer. Turn on the paste pot. And place it at the beginning of the now empty staff and press your pointing device button or return and they'll reappear. Okay. Here they are. Press it again and another copy of the song will appear, shoving the one already there over to the right to make room. Okay. So we're not gonna we're not going to do that. Well, let's just do it. They've told us to. Finally, to complete the round, you need to make copies down in the second set of lines so that they will start after Are You Sleeping has been played twice in the top set. You begin by putting one rest, like the one pictured in the box, in each of the first two measures. Okay, so I always forget which one is the half rest and the whole rest. So we want this one, I believe. So here we go with the teaching again. Rests are just like notes, only they mean this much silence instead of this much sound. Next, use the paste pot to put down two copies of the song next to the rests. Now, with only two more actions, your round will be ready to play. Okay, so hold on. So I think we're going to turn on, let's go like this, paste pot, and paste. Oh, this is exciting. And two copies. Okay, so I'm going to paste again because they told me to. Folks, my legs fall asleep so quickly. Ah! I have to keep switching legs. Ow. Death. Okay. Now, with only two more actions, your round will be ready to play. One, drag the bass clef off the bottom staff and replace it with the treble clef. Okay. So let's go back to this. Go back. Come here, bass clef. Come here. Boom.
Okay.
Then use the right arrow to scroll to the end of the song and put two rests in at the end of the music in the top staff so that our Oh, this is cool. I don't Whoa! Okay, that's some cool programming right there. That's really impressive, actually, for this computer. Look, how amazing is that? And again, the scrolling capability is afforded by... Oh, I just wanted to use my finger, which I can do too. Afforded by the extra chips on the Mockingboard sound card. So we want to put in two more whole rests up here. All right, so it should be ready, but let me just finish reading for completion's sake. To play your round, turn on home and get back to the start and turn on the piano. Let's listen to our amazing composition. Here we go. That's why they wanted us to paste it twice, the whole song. That was kind of awesome. J-Rod says, excellent work, thank you. That's so cool. That is so cool. All right. That section finishes with, to save it for future playing, see saving music on the reference card. So we could save that if we wanted to. Note, the cut and paste buffer will allow you to cut up to 9 measures at a time into it, provided the measures don't have too many notes in them. If you try to cut some number of measures containing more notes than the buffer will hold, you'll hear a beep and no cutting will take place. If that happens, just try cutting a smaller number of measures until you find a number that will work. Isn't that neat? So, we've confirmed, what do we learn tonight? That the KoalaPad is awesome. That I'm probably going to be playing around with this a lot in my own time. And I think that it's amazing, the capabilities of this program for its time, and the fact that it was programmed by a kid between 15 and 16 years old. So, pretty amazing. Will Harvey, if you're out there. Will Harvey, if you're out there, how old are you right now, actually? Let's take a look. I want to know. Do, 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 I'm looking for a copyright. Where's the copyright? Where's the copyright? It's right here. It's right here. 1983. He's 2 years older than I am. So he is somewhere around 36. That's wild! The guy who programmed this game when he was 15 basically is just like me. I had a teacher in high school, I'll leave you with this thought, a teacher in high school who would often, when he would present us a historical figure who had done something amazing at a young age, who was either, you know, close to his age or had accomplished a lot already by his age, he would sort of say, like, what do I bring to the table? Like, how about them Red Sox? I think that's what he would say, is how about them Red Sox? Meaning, that's all he's got is, how about sports? Because I haven't accomplished an amazing thing by the time I was 34. He was 15 in... Oh, that's right, he was 15 in 83. Oh, thank you, folks. You're right. So he's 51. I got really excited about seeing 1983. Did you see what I did? And I immediately was like, he was born in 83! So that's funny. Thank you for setting me right. So no. So he's not my age. But still, only 51 right now. That's cray. But yeah, erase everything I just said. I just got really excited about seeing 1983, and immediately my brain just interpreted it as birth year, which is really funny. Simon says, Ken Silverman, creator of the build engine, was also a mid-teen when he first programmed it. It went on to be used for some of the more famous FPS games of the 90s. Isn't that amazing, though? Like, you look at these games that are created by people who are so young, you know, and we have certain examples of video games that have been created entirely, almost, by one person. Or the bulk of it, the programming, the music, the art, have been made by one person. It's amazing the amount of talent that can rest in one brain. You know what I mean? I missed all the Picard talk, and I apologize. I have not watched Discovery because I got disturbed by something in an early episode, and I just decided I didn't want to live with the fear any further. I know that I've been told that the show doesn't do anything all that bad further on, but I can't shake the paranoia. And I don't know how they changed the Klingons. Da 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 dum. Vortex Queen says, isn't this amazing? You can connect to someone like Ed Annunziata easily on Twitter. I was considering tweeting our masterpiece at him, honestly. Let's all go say hi. Go say hi to whom? Ed Annunziata? Just all of you start adding him and being like, hi. Why don't we play our masterpiece one more time? Should we try to save it? Just to see if we can on our Apple IIe disc? I'm always sort of worried that the type of file we're saving is going to matter. That for some reason I keep thinking, this doesn't make any sense, but I keep thinking like, oh, I need a disc only for music. But all of these files should be able to coexist together. So why don't we... Where's my Apple IIe disc? Why don't we go ahead and try to save this? Then we can listen to our masterpiece while I try to find somebody to push you into. Just shove you on over into another stream. Alright, so saving... Oh, they said on the quick reference card. This is another thing that I really love about... old software is the quick reference card. So a lot of times they would distill down your manual experience into something that you would just keep out on your desk. Does anyone still do that? Do video games still do that? Computer games still do that? We could also load, there are actual songs already programmed on the disk that we could listen to. The Sonata in D Major, First Movement by Mozart. Let's see. If you hear a beep, to play music, loading and saving. To load the music, to save music to another disk, place the disk you want to save to in the drive. and then type save, followed by whatever name you want to use, and press return twice. Now, it's not saying put it into the second drive. It's just saying put it into the drive. So I am going to go ahead and put our Apple IIe disk into the first drive. Because sometimes programs will detect when you have more than one drive, and sometimes they don't. And since they didn't specify, and they didn't make it sound like I was going to be able to choose, just to be safe. So we're going to type type save. I kind of feel like I should be clicking on the save button here. There we go. Save, and we'll call it Picard. So save Picard, and then press return twice. Return the first disk drive is working. And I'm going to hit return again. Oh, I see. So that's cool. So it went ahead and saved it, and now it wants me to insert the music instruction set disk once again and press a key. And now it's accessing it again to get the software back up. Awesome. Cool. So that's saved. So in case we ever want to revisit our glorious achievement, we can. Oh, we were talking about Electronic Arts. This is the sleeve for the game, by the way. I didn't show off the actual game. I should do that. The actual disc. It's a cool color. It's actually gray for some reason. It's neat. Music construction set. For extended media life, here's how to take care of your flexible disc. Precision surface. No fingers, please. Magnetic fields erase. Keep them far away. Bending and folding may damage. Handle with care. For your disc's sake, and the system's too, insert disc carefully. Keep it safe in the envelope when not in use. Keep discs comfortable. Store at 10 degrees to 52 degrees Celsius, 50 to 125 degrees Fahrenheit. 125 degrees Fahrenheit, that's comfortable for a disc. That's so cute! Let's see. It's this one I want to show you. Can you read that? Keep discs comfortable. Words to live by. Okay, I'm going to put it back in the first slot just in case it needs to access the disc while it plays the track. Let me get some of this stuff off of my lap. Go. Let us turn this off. And this off. Okay, so now I can turn my laptop towards me so I can find someone to raid. Oh, let's listen to our masterpiece. I'm doing this upside down. There we go. So, we have Taco Salad streaming a Star Trek game, in fact, which I think is quite the coincidence. So why don't we go check out Taco Salad, who is playing Star Trek The Next Generation, A Final Unity. That's all I can read of the preview. That Star Trek game is super awesome, says Bogus. Simon says, I think Toddler Us have all done that at least once, Bogus. You even did that with a VHS tape once. Oh, what did you do? Bogus says, broke our disk drive as a kid by putting it in backwards and jamming it in. Oh, no! Did any of you... All right, question. This is a really random question. I'm going to get this raid set up, but did any of you watch the show called Johnny Time? It's Johnny Time! Does anybody know what I'm talking about? It was a show with one guy who acted out all these different character parts.
Sorry for that. Bing. Taco salad is 7-7, right? Yes. Not ringing a bell, no. I don't think anybody watched this show. He had a bunch of different characters that he played, and one of them was a little child. And one of the things the child said was, the child would, like, give advice. And the child was like, here's some advice. Never put a blueberry pancake into the VCR to watch your favorite shows. And I forget what else he said, but I used to... I said, waffles don't work either. it's funnier than I'm making it sound. Or at least I thought it was funny when I was growing up. But sometimes I think about that. I think about putting a waffle or a pancake into the VCR. Don't do it. Don't do it. It's not going to end well. So, folks, thanks for joining me for another Apple Tuesday. I had so much fun. I'm really excited about the potential and the possibilities with this software and the KoalaPad. It's kind of a dream come true because I always wanted one. So maybe I'll be participating in VG Keys, which would be excellent. Nude says you should eat them. So yeah, go say hi to Taco Salad. I'll be in there for a short time, and then I'm going to roll. But thanks again for joining me for Apple Tuesdays. I hope you have a wonderful night, and I'll see you Thursday for some kind of retro game or retro aesthetic game. I haven't quite decided yet what we're going to do. So I will leave it as a surprise. Have a good night.